Hello, my wonderful people. It's Chris Antoku, the Technical Enablement Manager here at Recast Software, back at you with a quick educational video. In today's video, we will be talking about how you can use Application Manager to deploy the Recast Agent and Recast Right-Click tools even without an Application Manager license. That's right. If you are currently licensed for Right-Click Tools Enterprise, you can absolutely use Application Manager to deploy the agent and console extension. The only prerequisite is having the Recast Management Server with Recast Proxy set up. If you are new to Recast, Application Manager is our third-party application lifecycle management solution with over 2,500 supported apps in the enterprise catalog. I won't get too into the weeds on it, but the Recast Agent with the Recast Management Server allows for added functionality that Right-Click Tools standalone does not offer out of the box. Some of the key features are the ability to perform actions on devices outside of the local network by utilizing the agent as the communication route. With the addition of the Recast Management Server, sysadmin can assign role-based access to their junior staff members, such as the help desk, and ensure they don't have additional access to things they don't need. Since the Recast Agent runs as the local system, it can run certain elevated actions a less privileged user may not have access to. Right-Click Tools standalone requires certain things to be enabled for all the tools to run without issues, such as remote WMI and remote registry. In a scenario where security is top of mind, the deployment and implementation of the Recast Agent allows for those protocols to not be enabled. The great thing about Recast Agents is that this is the same exact agent used by our analytics solution, Endpoint Insights, as well as our PAM solution, Privilege Manager. One server to bring them all, and one agent to rule them. You can find more information on the Recast Agent at docs.recastsoftware.com. There are some prerequisites that need to be met for Application Manager to be set up. A Recast proxy will need to be installed, which can be done during the RMS installation or separately. The Recast proxy uses a service account that sysadmin will provide with the proper permissions. Information for that can be found on our doc site on this page about proxy permissions, seen here. To be used for Application Manager, the Recast proxy account will need to have access to an SMB share where Application Manager will store its content. It will also need some Config Manager security roles to perform its tasks. At the very least, the read-only analyst and application administrator security roles. Unlike other third-party solutions that require you to assign full internet access, with Application Manager, you will only need to whitelist a couple of our API URLs. Now, are you ready to be empowered? Let's look at what it's all about. We are going to hop over to my demo environment where I have a Recast Management Server already configured. This is the central hub of everything Recast. First, let's look at what we are licensed for. If I expand Administration and click on the Licenses tab, you can see we are only licensed for Right-Click Tools Enterprise. This will also work in any scenario of our products if you have the Recast Management Server with Recast Proxy configured. We can now check to make sure everything else is set up before we start our Application Manager configuration. Next, let's look at our Proxies tab and verify our proxy is showing up, connected and authorized. After verifying that, we will also pop over to our Permissions tab and add my user account. There is also the ability to add an AD group here instead. Once we put the SAM account name in and select the account, we can click on our pencil icon next to it to assign it a role. I will be giving my account the administrator role. Let's launch an incognito window and navigate back to our RMS URL, then re-authenticate just to ensure those settings take effect. We will need to add the MEMCM service connection under service connections. I'll add a service connection and put in the information for my Config Manager instance. Then select our proxy information, check the Confirm checkbox, and click the Submit button. Now we can click the Test button to make sure that is working properly. We can also add our Active Directory connection and then test it for good measure. After that, we can finally click on the Application Manager tab and click Setup. The service connection we previously configured will be auto-populated, and we can put the UNC path in for the share we set up for Application Manager content. Click the Next button and choose a distribution point group you would like to make the content available to. Click the Next button. From here, we can skip this step, since we are going to add the deployment processes after Application Manager has been initially configured. Let's click the Next button. This will show a summary page of what we just set up, and at the bottom, here is the option to run the deployment process now or wait till later. Since we didn't add one, we can choose No and click the Submit button. We are greeted by the Congratulations splash screen. Once we click OK, the page will refresh and we have some additional tabs under Application Manager now. If we click on the Applications tab, we can see a list of the applications in the Application Manager standard catalog. This list is sorted by date last updated. Now we will move to the Deployment Processes page. This will be the main page where a sysadmin can see all the deployment processes they create. We will click on the Add Deployment Process button here in the upper right-hand corner. The flyover will pop up on the right where we can search for the Recast products. Let's choose our Recast Agent, and then after clicking Next, we can give the deployment process a name. We can leave the default and click Next. Here we will choose our initial collection to deploy these to. As always, we recommend following the best practices of deploying any new applications to a pilot or test group. I have one already, so I will choose that and click Save and Close. This will bring us into the Deployment Process Details pane. Here, I can choose when I would like to deploy this update. I will have it immediately deploy after an update becomes available, and by default, it will be set to required. At this point, if I wanted to, I could add as many deployment steps with whatever collections are needed for the process by clicking this plus icon and choosing another collection from the flyover. Then I can choose when to deploy that. For demo purposes, I will choose 3 days. So in this scenario, the application will deploy immediately to my test collection, and then after 3 days, it will deploy to the next collection. If you are familiar with creating applications in Config Manager, a lot of these same settings can be managed from this interface. If you want to learn more about the ins and outs of Application Manager, be sure to take the free courses available in the Recast Academy and get Application Manager certified. For our demo purposes, I am going to remove this collection I added and then click the Save button. Once we exit out of the Deployment Process Details page by clicking the X in the upper right-hand corner, we can add another deployment. In this case, we are going to add our right-click tools, accept the defaults, and deploy it to a collection. Now, in the Deployment Process Details, if I click on the gear icon here, the flyover for Deployment Process Settings will come up. Under the Advanced tab, I can scroll down to Additional Installation Parameters and add our RMS server in. This will add the syntax to the MSI installer string, which will connect right-click tools to our RMS. After scrolling down to the bottom, I can click the Save and Close button. Now this deployment process is ready, so we can click Save again, then close out of the Deployment Process Details. Now, on our Deployment Processes homepage, we can see our two deployment processes we created sitting in a pending run state. By default, the Application Manager process runs every half hour to check for new applications. So if we left this, it would run automatically. But we can manually kick them off by clicking the three dots on each deployment process and clicking Run. Now that this process has started running, Application Manager will, at a high level, download the content from our Azure storage locally. Once the content has been downloaded, it will move it to the SMB share we provided during the setup. After that step, Application Manager will utilize the Recast proxy account to add the application into Config Manager and add the deployments we set during the configuration. If I launch the Config Manager console and navigate to the Software Library node, then expand Application Management and Applications, a folder for Application Manager will show up. If the console was already open, a refresh may be needed. If I expand the Application Manager folder, we can see the folder for Recast Software, and under that is both Recast Agent and right-click tools. On the Recast Agent application, if I click on the Deployments tab, we can see the deployment I added has been created. Now, every time a new version of the Recast Agent and right-click tools becomes available, they will automatically be deployed and updated. Some additional information to consider. The Recast Agent will automatically add the install string to connect to your environment's Recast Management Server. Since we added that additional installation parameter to the right-click tools deployment process, that will also connect the console extension to the Recast Management Server. The Recast Agent will only deploy up to the version that the Recast Management Server is. So once the Recast Management Server has been updated, the Recast Agent will automatically update. That concludes our video on how to deploy the Recast Agent and right-click tools console extension using Application Manager. Thank you everyone for joining us for another Recast Software video. We appreciate every single one of you. If you are interested in learning more, we will leave links to the things we talked about in the description of this video. Feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions on the process.